Hi there. So I've been doing IRL streams recently here in Hong Kong, that is Hong Kong outside, and a couple of Twitch streamer friends were asking for help with getting sound alerts and TTS working on mobile. And I figured instead of showing them how to do it individually, I'd just make a video that could help them and perhaps you as well, you know, all at once, because IRL streaming is hard. So let's make it easier. I started streaming on desktop where everything is super customizable. I have these pretty chat bubbles. Channel point redemptions trigger sound alerts.
Oh, you see? They're all shiny Pokemon.
That was a little bit slow. Pokemon Go live streams on twitch.tv/AnthonyKelly. And when people subscribe, we get all this emote hype. I mean, it's fun. Get out the way, emotes. But I have had trouble trying to recreate this experience on mobile or IRL streams. Please, please tell me in the comments if you know of a good mobile live streaming app. Prism Live Studio is probably the most fully featured of the apps that I've tried, as it accepts third-party browser sources and can stream gameplay. But it's a bit buggy on my phone running Android 12. I still strongly suggest that you try it first, because it is a good app. Streamlabs Mobile, on the other hand, isn't great. The overlay editor is not intuitive at all, the app runs hot, and they straight up block all Stream Elements overlays, including these pretty chat bubbles by Zaytree. I love Stream Elements on mobile, and it runs Stream Elements overlays fine, but it doesn't support third-party browser sources, so I can't get my blurp sound alerts to work at all. Fortunately, I found an app called IRL Chat that runs in the background during streams and has been an absolute godsend for me. Let me show you how. Before going live, log in here with your Twitch account, and it will connect to your channel's Twitch chat. Chat will keep up to date in the background, even if you leave the app, which is super useful if you're streaming and you want to scroll back up chat to see who said what, or you want to time somebody out or something. IRL Chat also supports third-party browser sources, so for my blurp sound alerts, I can just paste the URL in here, and when the channel points are redeemed, it will play the sound out of my streaming phone speaker.
Okay, remember, catching a Pokemon is not about skill, so you can do this.
And it will get picked up by the phone's microphone. The streaming app doesn't need to play the alert itself. IRL Chat will do it for you.
Okay, so we're in a live streaming app right now. I do not have sound alerts set up within this app, but as we're on Android, I can run IRL Chat in the background. And hopefully, if I test the sound alert...
Hydrate or die,
people. Did you hear that?
On my setup, I've added a few different browser sources so I can see what's going on the stream, like, you know, who's followed or who has raided.
Did we just get raided?
Another great feature is text-to-speech. Whether you're an IRL streamer walking around town, a mobile streamer playing games, or someone streaming a road trip, it can be difficult or even dangerous to be looking at your phone all the time. TTS is so helpful, as it can read out every message sent to your chat.
AnthonyKellyIp says it's good to be able to hear chat when you can't read it.
Now, bear in mind that if you have TTS playing out of a speaker on your main streaming device and you get a lot of messages, it could get really annoying really fast for your viewers. And this is where my setup is a little bit different from most.
AnthonyKellyIp says, tell me when this gets irritating. Tell me when this gets irritating. Tell me when this gets irritating.
It's irritating almost at once. So because of that, I would suggest that you don't have TTS running on the phone that you're using. So what I do is I have a second device in my bag running sound alerts and running TTS as well. That way I get to hear what's going on in chat, but it doesn't annoy the people watching the stream.
I have IRL chat running on my streaming phone with sound alerts on for my viewers, but TTS turned off. I also keep a second device in my bag with IRL chat set up in exactly the same way, but with TTS turned on for me. If you see my streams, you'll notice me wearing headphones. Those are connected to that second device, and as I'm walking around, I get to hear everything said in chat, but I can keep my eyes on where I'm going.
But what if you're streaming from iPhone? Unfortunately, I don't think that there is an IRL chat equivalent that runs on iPhone. So if you want to get TTS in your headphones the same way that I do, you'd probably have to have a second Android device running in the background and pair it to your headphones. Fortunately, IRL Chat is a super light app and it would work on a budget Android device or an older Android device, no problem. But let's say you're streaming from iPhone and you really want your viewers to be able to hear sound alerts on stream. One thing that I've seen people do is carry a Bluetooth speaker connected to their second Android device. How loud is this actually going to be?
Long ways to die. So many long ways to die.
Yeah, that's a bit loud, but it could be fun actually having real sound effects playing on your stream with a Bluetooth speaker.
I'm not joking when I say that IRL chat has been a complete game changer for me. I'm not very good at walking and talking and looking at my phone all at the same time. So being able to get sound alerts and text-to-speech coming through my headphones makes IRL streaming so much easier.
We do sometimes get funny looks, sometimes, but most of the time it's like... Thank you for the follow. We do sometimes get funny looks.
Sure, every now and then the sound of chat can get a little bit too busy.
There's so many people. How are you doing, Frankly Prez? What were you doing? Frankly Prez says, how's the weather? Idol Zed says, amazing. Chipmunk Attack says, I'm ready for my egg event. I was just being bombarded with sound. It was amazing.
But the benefits of being able to focus on what you're doing on the stream far outweigh any issues that I've had so far. Thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you have any questions about how to use IRL chat, please pop them in the comments below. We will be streaming over on twitch.tv/AntonyKellyIp. I sometimes play Pokemon Go. I walk around Hong Kong. I do play a little bit of Fortnite sometimes. Not very good at it. But if any of that sounds interesting to you, then yeah, please drop on by. And I hope to see you next time. Peace and long life, guys. Bye-bye.
Oh my god, I love dodgems. Wait.